Okay, so we're going to use this graph to answer the questions here at the right. I guess I should say use the graphs of the two functions. I guess this should be gone. Okay, so we know to use this graph because it has an h here. All of these have h's, right? And this graph has an h there. So that's how we know A through F go with this particular graph here. Okay, so the first one asks us to find h of 1. So remember that this graph is labeled h of x right here. Well, instead of x, it's telling us to find out what the output is if we input an x. So it's asking us essentially this question here. What is y if the x is a 1? So we would need to look at the graph, and we would need to go to the x-axis here, and we need to go to 1, so this is 1 right here, and then we go to the point right there because it has this x value of 1 right there, and it wants to know what this point right here, which has an x of 1, the ordered pair for this point is 1, negative 3. So when we're asked to find f of 1, it means when x is 1, what is the output? So negative 3. So our answer here would be negative 3. Okay, the next question asks us to find the vertical intercept on h of x. So essentially, when we solve this problem, it's asking us this. It's asking us, where does the graph cross the vertical axis? So remember why it says vertical? It's this axis right here, but what if you don't use x and y? That's why it's more in a general term, vertical intercept, instead of saying, we could have said, where does it cross the y-axis? So if we look at this graph right here, here's the vertical number line right here. So it's asking, where will it cross that axis there? So it looks like it crosses right here at the origin. So our answer would be 0, 0. So 0, 0 is the vertical intercept. Okay, moving on, now we're asked to find the horizontal intercept. So the horizontal intercept is where the graph crosses instead of the vertical axis like the question before. Now it's asking us where it crosses the horizontal axis. So not this one anymore. Now we're talking about this one. So essentially that's typically the x-axis. So we're going to go ahead and now instead of this axis here, we want to know where this graph crosses the horizontal axis, the x-axis. So it crosses here and it crosses here. So it crosses at 0, 0. And it also crosses here. That point is at 4, 0. So and 4, 0. Okay, so this time it's asking us, what is x? So remember, x is the first number in the ordered pair. So it's asking us, what is that number? If the output, so we need to find x if the output, which if we're considering the output y, is negative 4. So we need to find out what numbers, what x numbers, what's the first number of the ordered pairs that have a y value, an output of negative 4? Okay, so since we want to find x, instead of looking at the x-axis, since the y or the output's negative 4, I'm going to scan my y-axis and I'm going to go to negative 4, which is right here. And the point on the graph that if I read this ordered pair is at 2 and then negative 4. So 2, negative 4. So if x was 2, the y is negative 4. So your answer is going to be 2. Okay, do not write your answer like this. That is wrong. That means you don't understand what the question is asking. All it asked for is, what is x? So just this number right here. That's all it asked for. It didn't ask for what is the ordered pair or anything like that. Okay, so now we're asked to find the domain. So we know what domain means. It means what are all the possible x values on what the function you are given. So since domain refers to the x values, and it's super easy for me to remember again, x comes before y in the alphabet, and domain comes before range in the alphabet. So the domain goes with the x values here. Okay, so the domain is what x's are used in this function. So we always go from the left to the right side. So here's the left side right here. And if we start, we could see that this graph here has an arrow going to the left. And since there's an arrow going to the left, that means this graph is going to keep going and going and going and going. It's going to go left infinitely. It's going to go left. Now, as we go to the right, there's points on the graph, there's points on the graph, there's points on the graph. And as we go right, it's going to go infinitely to the right side. So that means all the numbers on the right side of the graph are going to be x values. So that is our domain. So our domain would be negative infinity to infinity, because there's arrows going left and right, so it's going to go infinitely left and right. All right, so next, lastly, it asks us to find the range. And range is just, what are all the possible y values? So now we're going this way. And since the y-axis is vertical, we're going to go from the bottom to the top. Okay, so we're going to go from bottom to top when we read our range. Okay, so if we look at this graph here, we're going to start at the bottom. There are no arrows going down like this. It means that it doesn't go infinitely into the negatives and the y values. The graph will never go past this blue line right here. It's all above it. So in other words, this point right here is the lowest, the most bottom point on this graph. And that ordered pair is is 2, negative 4. So when we're doing our range is the y values. So this is x and this is y. So the most bottom y value here is negative 4. So we're going to put a bracket and a negative 4 because this is a solid circle. The line is solid at that point there. Okay, then we're going to go to the top. So we started at the bottom, and the most bottom point here was negative 4. And then as we go to the top, there's arrows going infinitely up. That means the graph keeps going up, and we're going to use an infinite amount of y values. Okay, so that is our range. Negative 4 to infinity.